Hello everyone. This is Jenny Kester from K-Readers. Reporter Sam is in Vietnam now. Let's hear the news from him. Sam?
Hello. This is Reporter Sam from Vietnam.
How's the weather in Vietnam?
It's rainy season at the moment. So it's hot, humid, and rains often. So be careful while driving. And thank you so much.
Thank you so much for the news. Okay, we heard the expressions of the weather. In Korean class, we will learn expressions about the weather. Before we start our program, I want to call my partner, Sam. Sam, we have to start our Korean class. Come out!
Hi.
Okay, hello Sam. Now Sam is here, so we can start our Korean class. And before we learn the weather expressions, let's have a review before we start. Sam, please.
로건 씨, 어디에 가십니까?
This sentence means, Mr. Rogan, where are you going?
저는 학교에 갑니다.
This sentence means, Miss Sola, are you going to a sorry. 저는 학 just now he said 저는 학교에 갑니다. So this sentence means I'm going to school.
솔라 씨는 식당에 가십니까?
This sentence means Miss Sola, are you going to a restaurant?
아니요. 식당에 가지 않습니다.
This sentence means Miss Sola is not going to restaurant.
저는 도서관에 갑니다.
This sentence means I'm going to the library.
제니 씨도 같이 도서관에 갑니다.
This sentence means Miss Jenny is going with me.
우리는 도서관에서 책을 읽습니다.
This sentence means we read book in the library.
Oh, you're doing really good. Okay, let's have a look at with today's expression.
The topic for today is how's the weather today? 오늘은 날씨가 어떻습니까?
오늘은 날씨가 어떻습니까? Wow, it looks very useful. It's very important in our daily lives.
Yes, today we will learn how to ask and answer questions about the weather in Korean. First, we will gonna read through. Okay, 오늘은 날씨가 어떻습니까?
날씨가 좋습니다.
덥습니까?
아니요, 덥지 않습니다.
춥습니까?
아니요, 춥지 않습니다. 오늘은 따뜻합니다.
1번은 요즘 날씨가 어떻습니까? Alright, let me explain one by one. Sam, let's go! Okay, first sentence is 오늘은 날씨가 어떻습니까? 오늘 means today. 날씨가 means the weather. 어떻습니까 means how is. So 오늘은 날씨가 어떻습니까 means how is the weather today.
Let's check with the pronunciation. I want to practice this word 어떻습니까 from this sentence. Like I told you, we don't pronounce how it is written. Say, 어떻습니까?
어떻습니까?
Okay, repeat after me. 어떻습니까?
어떻습니까?
Okay.
Okay, the next sentence is 날씨가 좋습니다.
날씨가 좋습니다.
Actually, you can remove the subject. So only 좋습니다 is okay. 좋습니다 means is fine. So 날씨가 좋습니다 means the weather is fine. 좋습니다.
좋습니다.
Yes, this part say like this. Repeat after me. 좋습니다.
좋습니다.
So now let's check the weather condition with the grammar.
Just now, we learned the sentence with this form. N stands for noun, and we have a special plan today. It's the adjective. Put the adjective whatever you want in this A part. Let me explain one by one.
So, in the place of N, put the subject, and the subject maker comes next. There are two kinds of subject maker, which are E and Ga today. Last time, we learned 은, 는. So, use this 이, 가, like them. If no 받침 in the subject, put 이. And if there is 받침, put 가.
And let's learn the plain adjective plus 블라 블라 비읍니다 or 씁니다. This is a big point for today. So, very important. When you want to say be adjective, use adjective plus 비읍니다 or 씁니다. It's the same pattern of the predicate which we learned last time. Let's see 날씨가 좋습니다 as an example. 좋습니다 is the predicate and it comes from 좋다. Here in 좋다, there is 받침. So, put 씁니다. Erase 다 and put 씁니다. Then it changed to 좋습니다. It means it's good.
Okay, next one is 날씨가 따뜻합니다.
날씨가 따뜻합니다.
따뜻합니다 comes from 따뜻하다, which is warm in English. 따뜻하다, there is 받침. So put 비읍니다. Erase 다 and add 비읍 under the 하 and then add 니다. So then 따뜻합니다 means it's warm. This is the point of the form.
I want to practice this word 따뜻합니다 from this sentence. Say 따뜻합니다. This is more natural. Okay? Repeat after me. 따뜻합니다.
따뜻합니다.
Okay.
Okay. And then the next sentence is 덥습니까? This is the question form. So like I said before, erase 다 in the end and put 습니까? Put 가. Then it becomes 덥습니까? This was the question form.
Easy, isn't it? Alright, let's go to the next sentence. Next sentence is 아니요, 덥지 않습니다. 아니요 means no, 덥지 means it's hot, 않습니다 means not. So this sentence means no, it's not hot. If someone asks, is the weather hot? You can answer in two ways.
First, you can answer 네, 덥습니다. Just say 네 to make it simple. It means yes. Let's learn the expressions of negative way. If the weather isn't hot, you can say 아니요, 덥지 않습니다. Let's learn how to make it negative sentence.
Use the form 블라블라지 않습니다, which we learned last time. For example, 날씨가 따뜻합니까? If you want to answer, it's not warm, what would you say?
First, the positive answer is 날씨가 따뜻합니다.
날씨가 따뜻합니다.
So erase the 비읍니다 form and add 지 않습니다 form. Then the answer will be 따뜻하지 않습니다.
따뜻하지 않습니다. Alright, let's practice with the question part and negative part again.
Okay, 날씨가 춥습니다. means it's cold. If you want to change this sentence to question form, put 가 instead of 다 and add question mark. 춥습니까?
춥습니까?
Repeat after me. 춥습니까?
춥습니까? And practice with the negative part. 춥습니다. Here, erase 습니다 and add 뭐뭐지 않습니다. The answer is right. 춥지 않습니다. Okay. Then if you add 아니요, it means no, it's not cold. Well done. Well done, everybody. 아니요, 춥지 않습니다. You're doing really well. Let's go to the next sentence.
The next sentence is 아니요, 춥지 않습니다. 오늘은 따뜻합니다. Okay, 아니요 means no. 춥지 않습니다 means it's not cold. So the first sentence means no, it isn't. Then let's go to the next sentence. 오늘 means today. 은 is subject maker. 따뜻합니다 means warm. So 오늘은 따뜻합니다 means it's warm today.
And the next sentence is 일본은 요즘 날씨가 어떻습니까? 일본 means Japan. 은 is subject maker. 요즘 means these days. 날씨 means weather. 가 is object maker. 어떻습니까 means how. So this sentence means how is the weather in Japan these days? Let me explain two parts of grammar here.
Okay. The third grammar point to learn is 엔, 이, 올, 가, 어떻습니까? You can use this expression when you want to ask about the condition of something. You just have to put the noun you want to in and. For example, if you want to ask what the weather is like, instead of an in the subject, put 날씨. 날씨. There is no 받침. So use 가 as a subject maker. And put 어떻습니까 in the end. The sentence 날씨가 어떻습니까 is completed. Repeat after me. 날씨가 어떻습니까?
날씨가 어떻습니까? Okay. You can ask not only 날씨, but also other words, and ask for the status of those words. If you want to ask what your clothes look like, instead of an in the subject, we use 이 옷, which means this clothes. 옷 has a 받침. So use 은 as a subject maker. And put 어떻습니까 in the end. The sentence 이 옷은 어떻습니까 is completed. Repeat after me. 이 옷은 어떻습니까?
이 옷은 어떻습니까? Okay. Using this grammatical structure, you can ask about a specific country and how it is. In that case, just put the country name instead of an in the subject. For example, if you want to say, how is Korea? 한국 is used instead of an as the subject. And 한국, there is 받침. So put 은 as a subject maker. And put 어떻습니까 in the end. Then the sentence 한국은 어떻습니까 is completed. Repeat after me. 한국은 어떻습니까?
한국은 어떻습니까? Alright, the last part of the grammar. The next form is noun plus adjective. Right before we learn 엔, 이, 월, 가 어떻습니까? You can answer using with this pattern. One thing, you can erase noun plus subject maker. Alright, let's make it easier not to get confused. Let's use the word 오늘은. Put the word whatever you want here in the noun place and add subject maker. Add the word of the adjective.
As an example, today is hot. It's hot in Korean. Use 오늘은 instead of noun 은 or 는 and put 날씨, which means weather, in noun place, second noun place, and the adjective is 덥습니다, which means hot. Then the sentence goes like 오늘은 날씨가 덥습니다.
오늘은 날씨가 덥습니다. Okay, another example. 오늘은 날씨가 좋지 않습니다. Means the weather is not good today in negative way. Like I said before, use 블라블라지 않습니다 next to adjective. The meaning of fine is 좋다, erase 다, and add 지 않습니다. Then it becomes 좋지 않습니다.
좋지 않습니다. How can I say the other way? Like the weather is bad. In that way, use the word 나쁘다, which means bad. This is the adjective. Like you see, there is no 받침. Erase 다 and add 비읍니다. Then it goes 나쁩니다. Let me continue. If you find difficult, review with the handout which we sent to you. And watching the YouTube channel 안녕 코리아 will help you understanding.
Okay, thank you for today and being with us.
We will see you next time.
안녕.
안녕.
잘 가.